So, I just went to the market and I just came back from the market and the idea struck me a little late that I could do a haul video. Like, it's the market, not like there's anything fancy to buy, but it's still fun, you know. But I realized it just now after emptying most of my bag. So I'm just gonna do half a haul, okay? I've already recorded the mangoes. I'm gonna insert them somewhere in this video. But let's start with what's still in my bag and I'll fill you up on the things that I've already emptied from the bag as well. So let's see what we have. So first up we have LED light. Okay, so I bought these LED lights because my fairy lights that I usually hang here have broken, and I tried to, not broken, but they're here, okay? And these are the multicolored ones, like they're blue, red and yellow, or blue and red or something. And I tried, after a very long time, I tried switching them on again, and they almost gave me a shock. Not a shock, like it was a proper short circuit that happened. Like I put it here and it kind of exploded here, and then it exploded at the electric box as well. And this was at like 2 a.m. okay, because I was feeling very restless at 2 a.m. I thought I'll try my lights and set in my lights for some time, and it scared the shit out of me when it happened. Like I was literally, after it happened, I ran and stood in the passage because I didn't know what to do, because like there was an mini explosion in my room. And I just stood there and I didn't move because Anisha was asleep, so I didn't know what to do. And I had to still come back in here and switch the main electric board off, because you can't leave that on, especially after a mini explosion just happened. And I was so scared. Anyway, that aside, basically those lights don't work anymore. These lights don't work anymore. So now I switched off the phone camera by mistake. Anyway, those lights don't work. So I bought these lights. These are a little different. So these are, it comes with double-sided tape here, so you take out this double-sided tape and you stick it on that's where I plan to stick it. Like I want to put it into that socket and I want to stick it along that top part of the thing, and it's pretty long, so I'm guessing it will go across there and across there. So I want to do it on that side of the wall, because that'll show into the room. I mean, I could also do it on this side, but this side already has this tiny little lamp which is really, really cute and pretty. One day I'll shoot a video in the night and show you. Anyway, so this is that, and he did this elaborate thing where he had to fix it to some adapter. It became almost twice its price after he did all of this, but I rather he did this, because without this it was just two bare pieces of wire. And he was like, just put these bare pieces of wire into the hole and switch it on. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? Do you know what happened in my room yesterday? Not yesterday, last week. But he was really sweet. All these guys in the bazaar are really sweet and kind. So they were like, nahi nahi, theek hai, main laga deta hu fir. And then he fixed this. I'm still a little iffy about this because it's all still tape. So I don't know, I'm gonna ask Anisha if she has more of this electric tape. And I'm gonna stick more into it, because you can never be too careful. Whew. I wish there was another camera that was recording my face, you know, like actual bloggers, but we don't have that, so you're gonna have to look at objects while I talk in the background. Okay, so that's my light. Please say a small prayer that my 550 rupees that I paid for when I'm broke isn't going waste, because I really wanted light. It really makes me happy. So I know that even though I'm a bit broke, if the light is actually gonna make me happy, it's fine. And you know, today when I was in the bazaar, I just thought to myself, even though I don't have the money to spend on these things, these guys who are selling me these things could use the money more than I could. So even though I spent like 1500 or 2000 bucks today, it's gone into people's pockets who actually need the money, you know. So every time, anywhere I went, I didn't bargain. Obviously I don't bargain anyway, but I let, if they quoted a price saying 450, I let them have the extra 50, because what am I gonna do with 50 bucks that they might need more than me, you know. Anyway, let's open more in the bag. Let's check what else is there. So I got this umbrella. I don't have an umbrella at the moment. The one I have is actually at Nattu's house, and I don't know when I'm gonna get it back. So I have decided to let go of that umbrella. Nattu, you can keep it, it's yours. So I got this from, so I scanned a lot of shops in the bazaar. There were so many people selling umbrellas, but I kind of make it a point to as far as possible try to buy from Muslim people, because obviously for obvious reasons they're more oppressed, and I'm sure people decide not to buy from them as a bias, as a stigma or as a taboo or whatever. So I'm pretty sure they anyway make less business than the other people. So I went to this nice uncle's shop and he was talking to me in English and telling me that they make this, these are family made umbrellas. They have a little workshop in Mahim opposite the station or opposite the church or something. He described it. He like gave me directions on how to get there. I just asked him, do you have a factory? And he gave me the whole thing about where it is and everything. And he said, I asked him, I want something in yellow. So he had this in yellow. It's really pretty. And he said, we only make stuff. We only sell stuff made in India. And this is our homemade item, our family made item. We have our own umbrellas. We don't sell any Chinese items. So I was like, okay, uncle, cool, thanks, I'll take it. Wow, I do not have the upper body strength to open this with one hand. So, or rather to open it with my left hand. Yeah. Okay. Here it is. It's super pretty. I love it. I love it. Even though it's a bit auntie with these ruffles, and especially with this. This is so characteristic of an auntie umbrella, where the handle just does not match the rest of it. Even the button is different from the rest of it. Like, come on. I guess the button comes... Okay, I don't know what it is, but anyway. So yeah, this is my most auntie umbrella ever, and I am proud. It was only 200 bucks, so I'm really happy that I was able to... Okay, BRB. Sorry about that, I had a work phone call to take. I'm back. And my things are as they are. So let's continue. Okay, this is my auntie umbrella, my grandma umbrella. That's very, it's very, you know, I like it because it's very, not only is it helping sustain a local business and an oppressed community in a way, but it's also very Bandra grandma chic. You know, that's my vibe. That's my vibe. So I like that. Anyway, next up is Siggy packets. Not for me. These are for Anisha, and she was really, really happy when she saw them. I took them back from her for the shoot because, like I told you, I'd already unpacked everything. So that's hers. Now cigarettes are really expensive. I don't know why they're still expensive, because clearly everything is still everything is back open. So this packet should ideally be only 200 bucks, but they're 300 bucks. So it was 600 for these two packets. Smoking is really one expensive habit that I'm so glad I've kicked, at least for the time being. You know, I don't know if it's gonna come back. I won't beat myself up about it if it comes back. Next, I bought two pairs of leggings, because the leggings that I have here have got a tear in them. You can probably even see it from here, and it's annoying because it chafes my thigh, so I've kind of got a rash here. So I really needed new leggings. Excuse me. I thought I'd stitch those leggings that were torn, and you know, kind of teach myself how to stitch and shit, but it's too far gone. Like, it's beyond repair, I feel. So I've got these really nice leggings only for 100 bucks from this really old uncle. Not really old, actually, old uncle who was chewing gutka, so he never said anything to me, he just kept nodding. But yeah, I'm excited to try these leggings, and I just hope they don't tear, yaar. Or at least like tear in a month, you know, at least last me a month. That's why, for safety's sake, I brought two, and both of different materials, so that if one tears, then maybe the other one won't. So that's what I got. What else is there here? There's some sanitizer. There's some bags I took from home so that I don't have to bring bags back home, which came handy for the mangoes. I also went to buy earphones. I did buy earphones last week. I bought these last week, and within the week, they stopped working. Like, they instantly stopped working. Instantly, not instantly. It worked for a week, and then it was like 1 second it was working and the next second it wasn't. Like, there was no warning. So I tried to go and exchange it with the same guy who sold it to me. I knew where he was sitting and everything, but he wasn't there today. And I'm not gonna come back and go back tomorrow just to exchange earphones. Doesn't make a bit of difference. So I decided to just buy another pair of earphones. I bought these from another guy named Vaseem. The same price, they're 100 bucks now, because market is bad is what they say. Well, I don't mind, it's not a lot of money, and that's why I don't mind even not exchanging these. I'm sure he has better use for the 100 rupees than I do. So I bought these, and now I fucking hope that they work. I told him to let me try it on his phone at least, but the guy who was selling it to me didn't have a cell phone. Like, he didn't have a cell phone. He went around to some other people who were selling stuff right beside him in the same space, and he said their phone, and nobody gave him their phone to try this out, and I felt so bad. I was like, fuck it, it's okay, I'll just take it home. And he only said, aap paas mein rehte ho kya? So I said, haan, main yahi rehti hu. So he said, go home, you listen to it, and if it doesn't work, you come back and exchange it, no problem. So I said, okay, fine, no problem, but just, I hope it doesn't stop working in a week. Then he was like, he said something really funny. He was like, why don't you then, every time you use the earphones, put the rest of it in this bag and then listen to it. So I was like, am I going to do that all the time? Everywhere I go, I'm going to hold this bag in my hand and listen to music. So then we both started laughing. But I was like, theek hai, no problem, whatever. Then I took these and I came. What else did I buy? So I bought myself a new yoga mat. Not a yoga mat, like an exercise mat. They're called yoga mats, so I'm not going to use it for yoga. You know what I can do? I can place this somewhere. Kahan place karun main? It is slippy material, like it's not gonna stay on the floor very tight, but it's fine because it's sturdy, you know, the one that Anisha has. It's somewhere here only. No, it's in the kitchen. It's really soft, so you know, if you put your finger in, it makes an impression, so you can't jump too much on it, you can't like scrape your toes like this, and sometimes you do scrape your toes when you're getting up and stuff. So I've kind of scraped her mat a little bit, and I'm not happy about that, so I decided it's finally time to buy my own mat, even though it's not perfect, even though it's not great. Maybe I'll do something where I put this under other things, like I put it maybe, of course I can't put it under this, it's too heavy. Maybe I'll put it under my desk there, or under my bed here, so that it kind of stays in place. And I don't mind if it's there forever and I never move it, because now when the rain starts, I'm going to have to exercise indoor all the time. So yeah, I guess that's it for my haul. Oh yeah, there were other things I'll just tell you about because I can't show them to you. Priya auntie asked me to get two things for her. One was a packet of loose kaju and one was a silver foil, so I got that for her. But yeah, I wish I thought about this earlier. I would have taken some video shots in the market also, so I could intersperse it with my incessant talking, but it's too late for that now, so you have to look at my face. I also bought one more thing. I bought a drawing book. It's in the kitchen, so I'm not gonna go get it. It's a regular drawing book. It's actually not as good as the drawing books I already have, but I wanted a drawing book because I need those nice pages to paint, but they weren't as nice. The pages weren't as nice, but I couldn't help it. And I really wanted to buy from this really old auntie. She's so sweet. I always see her, but I've never bought anything from her. So I bought a drawing book that I'm gonna paint in. And she was really kind. Like, the book was 44 bucks, so I gave her 50 and I said, it's okay, keep the change. But she was really sweet and she was like, no, how can I take more money from you? And then she started removing one coin of 6 rupees, she started removing, and then she got tired of that and she just removed 10 rupees and said, take the 10 rupees, you can keep the 4 rupees I don't want it. And I said, how can that happen, auntie? I can't do that. And then she, while doing that, she checked the book and she said, oh, it's 42 rupees, not 44. I'm sorry. And then she said, no, forget it. I don't want even the 2 rupees. Can you please keep it? I said, no, auntie. And then I took 2 rupees and I gave her. Anyway, that was a very sweet exchange that became boring while talking about it. Did I see anything else that was interesting? Yeah, actually, at the same drawing auntie, stationery shop auntie, the boy who gives us anda in the evenings, he comes with his cycle and he gives us anda in the evenings. He was at the drawing shop buying a notebook and a pen, and he was so kind and sweet. Not to me, to that auntie. I don't know if he recognized me because we were both wearing masks, but I recognized him. So maybe even he recognized me. And I wanted to buy his book for him. But then, I don't know, I felt like it would seem too patronizing. Like, I don't want to go there and be like, oh, you don't pay for it. I can pay for it. I'll pay for you. I don't know, I kind of wanted to do that, but I didn't do that. And anyway, he bought his book and his pen. And he paid for it all. I think it was 60 bucks. He paid for the entire thing in coins. Like, he took out a big, heavy stack of coins in his palm. And he was counting one by one, keeping one by one, keeping one. And he made, like, 60 rupees. And the auntie was so sweet to him. Like, she was so nice to him. She was like, you want to take this one will be a little cheaper than that one, etc, etc. Then, when I was buying these LED light thingies, there was an uncle there. Old uncle wearing a mask. I don't know what any of these people look like none of the people that I've bought from today. I wanted to familiarize myself with them, but they're wearing masks, so I don't know what they look like, and they'll never know what I look like. So I wanted to be like auntie, you know, auntie when she goes to the market, and we've gone to the market with her a couple of times to shop. She, from the beginning, from like setting out of the building till the entire market shopping is over, she knows everybody. She's walking the street and she's saying hi to this guy, she's saying hi to that guy in like 6 different languages, okay? If this guy speaks in Gujarati, she's saying hi to him in Gujarati, ordering from him in Gujarati. She'll go somewhere else, she'll be talking in Marathi. I mean, everybody knows her, and while she's walking, everybody's like, hello Priya, come buy from me, what do you want today? It's like that authentic lived-in local feel, and I've been here for 2 years and I barely know anybody. Like, I know my vendors on like Hill Road, and I know my chart guy, and I know my city guy. Haven't seen them in months now. I don't know when I'll see them again. And market, I don't really go into the market that much unless we need something that we don't get, because auntie gives us all our food, you know. So we only go in when we need like stationery supplies, or if we need something from the chemist, or you know, stuff like that, fruits or whatever. Not that much. So nobody really knows us. Though we recognize each other, it's not like a, you know, colloquial basis where I'm just walking by and be like, hi. I have that with my other guys, not with these guys. So I thought, let me start to ask these guys their names and, you know, familiarize myself with them. But everyone's wearing masks. So yeah, at the electric shop, there was this old uncle. He was wearing a watchman's uniform and he was buying a table fan. And his watchman ka uniform said Resita. So I guess that's the name of his building. And I'm assuming maybe the table fan is for him. So I wanted to know more, you know, I wanted to ask him, and he was haggling a bit about the table fan because it was like 1800 and he was like, can you please make it 1700, nice 1700. And the electric guy was like, I already made it less for you, it was 2100, I've made it 1800 uncle, how can I do more? And the electric guy was also so sweet, he was so kind. I really wish I could see his face and he could see mine, because I want to know him, I want to smile at him, I couldn't. But yeah, then that uncle, he was very hesitant about buying the table fan. He was old, so I don't know, maybe he didn't know how to put it together. And I'm sure the building wale will expect the watchman to put the watchman's fan together, right? And I guess he didn't know how to. So he told the electric guy, aap hi laga ke de do, mujhe nahi pata. Then that uncle, the electric guy, put the whole table fan together for him. It was a really cute thing, and I was watching the whole thing because my LED light ka adapting situation was taking some time. But I had so much fun standing there because I could see a lot of these different people come and buy random ass things that I didn't even know existed. I still don't know what they are. They're like, people brought random ass pieces of objects and showed it to that man, and that man automatically knew what the other guy wanted, and he'd bring a part that fit right into it. I still don't know what those things were. It looked like a street light to me. I don't know what it was. But yeah. Did I buy anything else? Did I see anything else? No. But you know, when I was walking through the market, I could hear these bhajiwalas tell their old auntie customers who are haggling with them, saying, "Arey auntie, market kitna bura hai, koi nahi khareed raha hai," and stuff like that, and it felt really bad. So I hate that things are opening up and people are on the streets again and the disease is gonna spread. And I am terrified when I was out there that it was gonna, I would catch it somehow. I still know that, touch wood, I might recover because I'm young. I have the facility to quarantine myself at home if I need to. I have someone that will help me out. I have only two people in the house, so the transmission will be, chances will be lower. I don't have any old people living with me. I am very privileged right now. But these guys, even though their lives are at risk, they're making money. So, you know, I don't know. I'm glad about that. Not. Wow, 14 minutes. Fuck. I guess I'm gonna stop it here. Did I buy anything else? No. But it was a fun walk in the market. I missed it. I love doing it. It gives me such authentic Bandra feels, you know. Like, I actually live in one of those parts of Bombay where they haven't ripped it out to make it a skyscraper yet. And it's still rooftop houses, and it's still one-story houses, and it's still... Like, Bandra doesn't have a mall. Sorry. Look, I live in a part of the city that doesn't have a mall. I'm so happy. I'm so glad. I know right opposite my house, there is a big-ass supermarket, and there's a big-ass cinema... Whatever. What's it called? Cinema complex. Cineplex? But then... On that side of the house is all of that development, and on this side of the house is this. It's rooftop houses and it's two-story houses and it's Bandra aunties and it's old architecture, buildings that have been there since the 60s, since the 50s. So yeah, I love walking in the market and I love looking at people buying stuff, people selling stuff. See the different kinds of things that are there to sell. Like, you know, today I noticed, and I wasn't even trying, okay? I was just waiting at the electric uncle's shop. Yeah, that took a lot of time. I was there for a long time. And he's not an uncle, he's a young guy, but whatever. The electric shop. And when I was standing there and just staring around, I saw one auntie in a kashta. She was selling coconuts after, while... Okay, BRB.